Thanks for tuning in to thelonewolf.com. My name is Drew. Today, we're going to be taking a look at the new TRP DHR Evo Brake. The DHR Evo, despite the name, is not just a downhill race brake. It is what TRP is considering their flagship top-of-the-line brake. Can be used for aggressive trail riders, enduro riders, and yes, it is e-bike certified. Something that gets us really excited because we are now converted e-bikers. I know, surprising. First thing that might jump out to you guys is the size of this huge rotor right here. This is a standard rotor, which we're gonna be mounting on the rear of our bike. Next to it is the 223 millimeter front rotor that we're gonna be mounting on the front of our Trek rail. The new rotors are 2.3 millimeters thick, whereas a standard brake rotor is typically 1.8 millimeters thick. The 2.3 millimeter rotors resist warping due to heat by up to 47% more than a standard 1.8 rotor. The size increase obviously isn't just to go along with e-bikes becoming more popular. Over the years, bikes have changed, wheel sizes changed, so it makes sense that as speeds and wheels have increased in diameter, so should brake rotors. So moving on from the rotors, we'll get into the brake system itself. As always with TRP, their attention to detail is really impressive. All the machine work, the finish, the fit, I mean, everything is top notch in this brake. So one of the major changes that they've done in terms of performance improvement on the new caliper is they've changed the way that the oil flows through the caliper, better managing heat. It's designed to help reduce heat pools and therefore reducing brake fade, keeping brake power higher and more consistent, especially on long descents. Now, inside the brake caliper are all new resin pads. TRP was a little bit vague when we asked them what exactly was different about the new resin pads and how they came upon this new recipe, but they guaranteed us that the break-in process, the quiet ride would still be there, but we would have a better initial bite, more consistent feel, and just generally better stopping power when we needed it. TRP made several changes to get a lot more power out of the new brakes. One of the things TRP changed was the hose diameter. They went from 5.5 millimeters to 5 millimeters. Now, this obviously makes routing through the frame easier because it is a stiffer and slightly narrower hose, but it also helps with the modulation and control of the brake. When mounted up to the new lever, power transfer of the hydraulic fluid to the brake is a lot better. It's a bit snappier and definitely delivers a lot more power to the brakes. So once we get to look at the brake lever and master cylinder in detail, we find even more improvements have been made that are gonna give a better feel on the bike. TRP is now using 9mm piston and leverage ratio, which is increasing power in the labs by 62%. They've said that their test riders and our test riders who've already been on the brakes are not denying that the power increase is massive. So with that 62% increase in braking power in the lab, what does that transfer to on the trail? It means that there is a bit more bite. Our test rider that's been on them so far has reported he's kind of having to relearn his braking points, but he's noticing that he's able to brake a little bit later or kind of let off the brakes a bit sooner and get back up to speed because he's got the confidence that when he does need to scrub speed, he can do it very quickly and easily. So another thing that TRP has worked on to increase the braking power and consistency of their brake is mineral oil. The way that they've changed the viscosity and heat management of the mineral oil, they were able to change the boiling point of the mineral oil from 180 degrees Celsius to 230 degrees Celsius. That's a massive jump in temperature management. So, you know, your brake is not gonna be boiling, your fluid's not gonna go black and need to be bled and changed quite as much. And it's really just gonna mean your brakes work better, longer, and more consistently. Got about three rides in, several thousand feet of descending, and are really impressed with the power control, modulation, and the heat management of these brakes. Again, I'm really trying to abuse these things. I did a whole run yesterday down a 2,000 foot descent where I only used the rear brake, just trying to boil them over, trying to scorch rotors and pads, and I've been absolutely blown away so far. So just gonna dial in the cockpit a little bit more, and really excited to have these powerful brakes on our bikes and get a review to you guys in the near future. So stay tuned. 15 and a half feet from 20 to 0. It's pretty impressive. Wow.